Dear students, welcome to our electromagnetic theory course. Today we will discuss about some fundamental concepts related to vector calculus. These concepts are simple concepts. Of course, they are very easy, but we require this minimum knowledge in order to enter into our subject electromagnetic field theory. In today's class, we will discuss about some vector calculus basics. What is meant by unit vector? What is the importance of unit vector? What is distance vector? Why it is called as distance vector? And next, special case of distance vector, that is position vector, and vector algebra, means vector addition, subtraction, vectors multiplication. Okay, if time permits, we will discuss all these things. Otherwise, I will stop this video in the middle of the vector algebra. In next class, we will discuss remaining part. So I am dividing this concept into, I will make two videos. Okay, one is part one and another one is part two. This is a very, I can say, it is a fundamental concept and it is very easy. Vector calculus, vector calculus. In this, we will discuss about what vector calculus, basics, vector calculus, basics part 1. First of all, what is meant by vector? Our electromagnetic physical quantities, electromagnetic physical quantities can be classified as scalar quantities as well as vector quantities. What is meant by a scalar? It is a quantity which has only magnitude. It is a quantity which has only magnitude. And what about vector? Vector, it is a quantity which has magnitude as well as direction. Magnitude as well as a direction. That means what? If you want to represent a scalar quantity, magnitude is enough. Whereas if you want to represent a vector quantity, in that case we require the knowledge of the its magnitude as well as its direction. Okay, what are the examples for the scalar quantities? For this one, examples are nothing but, for this one, examples are nothing but what? Ex are easy, standard notation is easy example. So first one is mass and another one is temperature. Mass, temperature, work, electric potential. I am writing this as E potential. E potential means electric or potential. Now vector is nothing but what? It has magnitude as well as a direction. Examples are nothing but, for this case, velocity. Of course, displacement is also vector quantity. Displacement, electric field intensity, E intensity means electric field intensity. Magnetic field intensity, of course magnetic field is represented by H, so that's why H intensity. These are the some of the examples for the vectors. Now how we can represent these scalar quantities? Scalar quantity, let us say a temperature is equal to what? Some 30 degrees centigrade, or else room temperature 25 degrees centigrade, like this. We can represent the temperature like this. Here we didn't mention about the direction. And if you want to represent the vector, we require the knowledge of what velocity. It is 2 meters per second in north direction. In north direction. Okay, or else let us say it is 2 kilometers per second in north direction. My bike speed, train speed is 2 kilometers per second in north direction, whereas 1 kilometer per second in south direction. Or else instead of taking train, let us take boat speed. Okay. 2 kilometers in one of the direction, let us say north direction, opposite to that 1 kilometer per second in south direction. That means if you want to represent the vector, we require knowledge of what this represents the magnitude, whereas these are what representing the directions. Of course, the vector representation can be represented like this. Suppose if I have a vector b, vector is represented by like this, that is b bar. B bar, that is nothing but where you have these quantities, electromagnetic field quantities. Okay, let us say it is one of the quantity of our electromagnetic fields. So these fields we can find in the space, okay, surrounding us. Means we have the fields here in the space, here somewhere. Okay, if there exists electromagnetic wave, there is a possibility of the electromagnetic fields. That fields, let us say one of the vector field, that is electromagnetic vector field, is represented like this, B bar. Of course, it is a magnetic flux density. B is represented as magnetic flux is represented by B. Okay. In order to represent this one, okay, we require the knowledge of what coordinate system. Basically, coordinate systems are used to represent what? A point in the space. A point in the space. A point in the space can be represented as what? That is P of x comma y comma z. Means here I have a coordinate system like this. It is, let us take, it is your x axis, y axis and z axis. Let us say your point P, this one is nothing but what? Let us say it is your point P, that is x comma y comma z. Okay. In this case, we can represent vector like this. Basically, it has magnitude along x direction. So the magnitude of B along x direction is Bx. It is magnitude, but we need to represent what? A direction. For that purpose, we need to go for what? A vector called as unit vector. Means it is the magnitude part, it is a direction part. This Ax is called as what? Unit vector along the x direction. Unit vector means what? The magnitude of this one is equal to what? 1 only. Here I said that the magnitude of B along x direction is Bx. Means it should represent what? Direction only. Basically, these type of unit vectors are used to represent the direction only. Okay? The magnitude of unit vector is 1. Clear? Similarly, along y direction, it is what? By, ay. Along z direction, it is bz, az. This is about the vector representation. What about bx, by, bz? Bx, by, bz are nothing but what? Magnitudes of b, magnitudes of vector b along x comma y and z directions respectively. Okay, means bx is the magnitude of vector b along x direction, whereas bz is the magnitude of b along z direction. Now coming to here, I have what? Ax comma ay comma az. These are called as what? Unit vectors unit vectors along x axis, x, y and z axis, where these x, y, z are mutually perpendicular to each other. X is perpendicular to y, y is perpendicular to z. Basically, we have to represent this x like this. This x is maybe into the board or out of the board. This board is a 2D one. That means here we have 2D plane, but we want to represent what? Here we are representing what? That 3D diagram. We can't represent 3D on the 2D plane. Okay? Means here this one is perpendicular to what? This is perpendicular to what? This plane na? That is what? Plane is what? YZ plane. Here I can see the YZ plane. Means it is perpendicular to both Y and Z. That X is perpendicular to both Y and Z. It may be towards you. It may be towards you or into the board. Suppose if it is positive direction, this one is into the board is taken as negative direction. Okay, depending upon the notation used, you may take into the direction as positive or into the board direction is taken as positive, out of the board is taken as negative. Okay. Now this is all about the scalar, vector and vector representation. Now here I have what? Bx, by, bz are the magnitudes of b along x, y, z. Then what about the whole magnitude? That means the magnitude of b is given by, we have the formula. That formula is nothing but what? Under root bx square plus by square plus bz square. Okay? This is the magnitude formula of a given vector. Okay? Next, here we have ax, ay, az. We will discuss about these unit vectors. What is meant by unit vector? Basically, it is a vector quantity. What that word unit indicates? What that word in the unit vector, you have word unit that indicates what? The magnitude of unit vector is equal to unity. The magnitude of unit vector is equal to unity. What is the importance of unit vector? Already I told that in the representation of B, B is equal to what? Bx, Ax plus By, Ay plus Bz, Az. Okay. The magnitude of this one is what? That is mod B bar is equal to what? Under root Bx square plus By square plus Bz square. Okay. Now move on to our unit vector. What is this unit vector? It is a vector quantity used to represent what? It represents the direction. Represents the direction of a given vector. And what about magnitude? Magnitude of unit vector, that is mod unit vector, is equal to what? 1. Suppose I have a vector A, as vector is represented as what? X component of A as Ax into Ax. Y component of A is Ay. That means magnitude along y direction of vector A is Ay into Ay. Magnitude along z direction of vector A bar is az. Okay, if suppose these terms, that is ay, az are 0, then I have what I am saying here. If ay, az are 0, in that case I have what? A bar equal to what? Ax, Ax. Then unit vector is what? Ax, A bar by Ax. For this case, for the given case, vector is represented like this. Means magnitude along y direction is taken as 0, magnitude along z direction is 0. Okay. In a particular direction, magnitude may be 0 or it may be non-0. Here I consider non-zero zero along the y direction, z direction, whereas along x direction it is non-zero. The magnitude is equal to what? Ax. Now we can say that, okay, sorry, a bar by, from this I can write like this. What is ax? Ax is nothing but what? Magnitude of the given vector, na? Means I can write like this. So that's why the formula for unit vector, we can write what? Unit vector is equal to what? Vector by its magnitude. Vector by its magnitude. That means vector by mod of that vector, given vector. Let us find the magnitude of this vector is nothing but what? Like this only. Suppose if I have ax, ay, az, in that case how I can find the unit vector of this a? So I can find the unit vector of this capital A, means A is the unit vector of the given vector A, equal to what? What is the formula? I told that vector by its magnitude, that is what like this. Now I can write this as what? That is A, that is vector is A bar and its magnitude is mod A bar. What is the formula for that mod A bar? Mod A bar is nothing but what? Under root AX square plus AY square plus AZ square. This is the formula for the given vector. Suppose if I have a vector like this, let us say find a unit vector of the unit vector of P, or else unit vector along the P. P is given as what? Let us say 2ax plus 3ay plus 4az. 2ax plus 3ay plus 4az. In that case, we will get that is P bar equal to what? Vector is what? Sorry. Unit vector along P direction is represented as AP. Or else unit vector of P is nothing but what? That is AP is equal to what? It is AP, not TS. AP means what? Unit vector of the P, or else unit vector along P, equal to what? That is 2ax plus 3ay plus 4az, and formula is what? Mod of this P. P bar by mod P, that is what? Under root 2 square plus 3 square plus 4 square. Simplify this one, you will get what? Unit vector along the P direction. What I said, the magnitude of unit vector is equal to what? 1. If I find that magnitude, that is mod AP, what is the formula? I need to find magnitude in the denominator. What I have? 2 square plus 3 square plus 4 square. And in the numerator, I need to find mod of this one. How I can find mod? Mod of any vector is nothing but what? Under root x component whole square. What is the x component whole square? 2 square plus 3 square plus 4 square. Now I can cancel this 4 square, 4 square. 2 square, 2 square. Not like that. This thing is equal to this one, so that's why. Can cancel. Now mod AP bar is equal to what? 1. Now we can say that what? Basically, this unit vector is used to represent the what? Direction along P. Means the importance of unit vector is what? It is used to represent the direction. And what about the magnitude of unit vector? Is equal to 1. This is all about the unit vector. Now we will discuss another type of vector. Unit vector is over. And another vector is what? A distance vector. Distance vector. In the name itself, we have what? A distance. Okay. The distance between this object and me is nothing but what? Here I have one point and another point is here. Okay. I need to consider two points. Here also one point, that is, let us say it is your P and it is a Q. First point, I am taking this as R else. Let us write like this. Take this X, Y, Z. it may be out of the board. Basically, this may be x-axis is out of the board or into the board or towards you or into the board. Clear? Now, consider two points in the plane. That is, I am taking random points. That is P. P has what? X1, Y1, Z1. These are the variables. This may be anything, zero or non-zero, whatever it may be. And another point, that is Q. Q is what? X2, comma, Y2, comma, Z2. Let us join these two points. Okay? And if I represent like this, that is, means what? It is moving from P to Q. The vector is from P to Q. In this case, P is called as starting point and Q is called as a terminating point. Or else, P is what? Starting point, Q is ending point. Okay? In this case, I can represent vector like this, that is PQ bar, or else PQ arrow. We can represent like this vector, that is PQ bar, or PQ, and at the top we can write, at the top of this one we can write arrow like this. That means what? P is starting point, Q is ending point. Clear? If you first find the magnitude of that PQ, means the distance between these two points is nothing but what? We know the formula. The distance between that, okay, distance formula is equal to what? Distance equal to what? That is distance between P and Q is equal to what? Under root x2 minus x1 whole square, under root x2 minus x1 whole square, y2 minus y1 whole square, y2 minus y1 whole square, plus z2 minus z1 whole square, z2 minus z1 whole square. Let us assume, or else first see this one. What you have? This is x component. This is what? Y component. This is what? Z component. What I said, a vector representation is nothing but what? Suppose I have a vector A. A equal to what? A bar equal to AX. A bar equal to what? AX, AX. Plus AY, AY. Plus AZ, AZ. Now tell me, what about the magnitude of this vector? What about the magnitude of this vector? This is a vector. Magnitude is equal to what? Distance between two points. That is, distance formula is like this. It is nothing but what? Magnitude of the vector. We know the magnitude formula, that is mod A bar equal to what? Under root AX square plus under root AY square plus AZ square. Similarly, here I have what? X component whole square, Y component whole square, Z component whole square. Now I can write this PQ bar as what? AX, AX means X component is what? X component is what? Only I need to consider the X component, means let us take, assume this as 0, this as also 0. In that case, under root X2 minus X1 whole square, which is equivalent to what? X2 minus X1 into AX. Similarly, if I go for only along y direction, means what? Along y direction means I need to consider the y components. Remaining are zeros means what? I have only under root y2 minus y1 whole square. That is nothing but what? Only y2 minus y1. It is along a y direction, that is AY. And last one, that is only z, means remain, okay, make these components, assume these components are 0. We require only along z direction, means under root z2 minus z1 whole square is nothing but what? z2 minus z1 into AZ. Now find magnitude of that vector, mod of that PQ bar, or else PQ, okay, PQ arrow, that equal to what? Under root x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square plus z2 minus z1 whole square, which is nothing but what? Distance between two points. This is the formula for what? Distance between two points. Here, the magnitude of this vector is equal to the distance between two points. That's why this vector is called as what? Distance vector. Why it is called as distance vector? Because its magnitude is equal to the distance between two points. Clear? Now move on to another vector. That vector is called as position vector. That vector is called as what? Position vector. Position, I am writing here, position vector. What is this position vector? It is nothing but a special case of distance vector. A special case of distance vector, where we have a point P of x comma y comma z. We need to find the position of this vector with respect to origin in case of the position vector. Means in case of position vector, in case of position vector, we have two points like this, here P and Q. In that case, O and P, where starting point should be origin. Starting point should be origin. Here our origin, that is 0, 0, 0, and here point P, I am representing point P like this. It is x comma y comma z. Then I will get a vector like this. This is starting point like this, and ending point can be represented like this, terminating point, or else this is called as the tip of the vector. This arrow indicates what? Tip of the vector. Okay, if you go to the restaurant after completion of our dinner or lunch, okay, at the end, okay, when you want to come out from the restaurant, you need to pay something. That is called as what? Tip. Tip to what? Okay, for the service. Here also this one is what? Tip at the end, at the end of your dinner. Okay, here at the end of the, that means it is ending point. Here this is called as what? Tip of the vector, whereas this is called as tail of the vector, or else we can call this as what? End of the vector. End of the vector. Okay, who leads the family? Head, like this. Next, OP is nothing but what? Now apply this formula, x2 minus x1. Here x1, y1, z1 is 0, 0. x2, y2, z2 is x comma y comma z. Just apply this formula, you will get what? First one is what? X minus 0 ax. X minus 0 into ax gives what? X ax. Similarly, along y, y, ay. Along z, z, az. Now, the magnitude of this vector is nothing but what? Under root x square plus y square plus z square. These are coordinates of what? Point P. Okay, the magnitude is related to this point P, and the position vector basically used to represent what? Position of this point P with respect to origin. That's why it is called as the position vector. Of course, a position vector is represented by small r bar, that is r bar equal to what? Mod r bar. Here r bar equal to what? R bar equal to what? OP bar. This is all about the position vector. Up to now what we have discussed? Vector definition, scalar definition. Vector can be represented with the help of its magnitude and direction. Means if you want to represent the vector, we require the knowledge of the its magnitude and direction, and after that representation of the vector. Next, unit vector. Unit vector is used to represent the direction. The magnitude of unit vector is what? 1. And distance vector, it is the vector whose magnitude equal to the distance between two points. That's why it is called as distance vector. And after that, position vector. What is position vector? Position vector is nothing but a special case of the distance vector, where starting point is origin and terminating point is the given point, like P of x comma y comma z, where x, y, z are variables.